Hello everybody and welcome back to another video. Today is just a grinding day because I'm waiting for the Robux that I just got to come in. But I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Honestly, I went into OBS studio thinking, you know what, it's about time I record a video. And what? Sorry, I just had a pop up for something about my drives. Guys, I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. If not, I hope I can make your day wonderful. Alright. And, let's try and hit our, like, goal of exactly one like. I know it's gonna be a hard one, but one like. And, if we can, then, you guys are just awesome. If you haven't, go ahead and click that subscribe button. Punch it, smack it, whatever you need to do. Or even just tap it. It doesn't matter to me how you press that subscribe button, but please do. It helps me out a ton, and it encourages me to make more videos. And also, I had a comment from the Daycare Rec Room show, which I'm actually voice acting Blood Moon, and so I'm the canon voice for the show. Let's see. So, guys, one way how I grind is just by my quest. Literally all I do. Just do my quest. I use observation and haki, and I use rainbow haki, which I will be showing you guys where to go to be able to find him. If you're not at the level 1950 or 1950, you will not be able to access it the regular way. Which I don't know if Bloxfords will patch this for me showing you guys, but let's hope that they don't. So, first off, let me, get up in levels. Sorry about the mic, guys. I've been looking into the gates. I can't find it. Either that or it's called something else. Because I'm on an older version of OBS Studio as this is being recorded. It is currently Monday, Halloween day. Guys, happy Halloween. And, depends on whenever you're watching this, have a happy Christmas. Or Merry Christmas. But, today I changed my avatar just a little to look more Halloween-y. Also, if you guys may not notice, I changed my character to Blocky. Yes, that was on purpose. That was because the electric claw doesn't look right, and I want you guys to have the best quality videos that I can give y'all. So, what did I do? Change my avatar. Hope you guys enjoy the new look. Guys, it really means a lot to me whenever you view my videos. Guys, my mic for my usual input actually crashed, so I'm using the straight up mic. Can you guys? Y'all can't see the error, but I have a voice mod beta, and it just seems to be crashing in the mornings. So I don't know what that's about. Hope you guys. That was weird. I just heard myself because it crashed, and it does that sometimes. So. Guys, if you want to try out for my Blox crew, we have 10 slots open. The way how you can do it is you have to beat me. It can be with your friends or whatever, but only one of you can enter. And I will be doing a giveaway in my Discord server, which I will be setting up right after this video. Now, if you want to join the crew and have benefits, which means free raids, and also free protection whenever I'm in your server, or any of us are. This also means that, I forgot what I was gonna do. Oh yeah, I was gonna show you how to get Rainbow Haki. So guys, I'll be showing you guys how to get Rainbow Haki today. So as you can see, I currently have it on. And this is just regular Rainbow Haki. You have to have full body haki. Doesn't matter what your visuals look like. It just has to be full body. So, how do you get Rainbow Haki? Well, Rainbow Haki usually starts out from stage 1 to 3. It is 900 hits for those three stages. Then 3 to 5, which 5 is the final, is 6,000 hits for the last two haki stages. Now, I actually was fighting Tidekeeper and randomly found it. Now, if you guys don't know where Mansion is, it is on Turtle. Floating turtle. And it is near this big tree, which we will be getting to. So over there is where where you would actually, if you don't have portals, you would usually, or if you didn't travel by portal, you would usually come on over here. Now, the reason, guys, why I am jumping and dashing at the same time is because it actually makes you faster. Now, on to the getting a Rainbow Haki part. Since I have it myself, I won't be able to show you guys. And so, I will be showing you the guide that will allow you to. And pretty much, you gotta defeat every non-special boss. But that also includes Beautiful Pirate. So you talk to this guy. He'll say this whenever you have Rainbow Haki. And Rainbow Haki is actually a secret color. So I will be showing you guys where all the bosses is and are. Don't know if that's how you say it, but... I just woke up and did school, and so. But, we have to go to Port Town first. And it would actually probably be faster if I used portals. And, you guys, the reason why I have so much cash and Blox fruits is because I grind way too much. And I grind way too fast. Too fast, in fact, that I've all the fighting styles. except for Water Kung Fu V2. I have Electric Law currently. These guys have Haki, which I just realized. How did I not realize that before? Besides from that, I will be trying to get Haki V2 today. So, basically what you want to do is you want to go to Hydra Island and, actually, here, is gonna be Lady Empress. Now, I'm sure if you guys already are level 1950, you already have defeated Lady Empress. She has, Beautiful Pyre. It has two stages and uses the Canvater. I got it first try, so I don't know how rare it is. But basically, let me go ahead and show you. So, and then we're gonna get to Stone, then the Empress, and then all the others. So you wanna go around about here. Then you wanna shift lock, or if it's mobile, you wanna press the bottom right. Then you want to flash step. And then you want to dash, so make sure you have enough energy. And then, see, we're at Beautiful Pirate Domain. I don't have to use this way anymore, since I do have it unlocked. But, basically, you want to go into this one. And hold on, I'll show you. Which you probably saw whenever I was entering. But it is basically, so this is, that's where you can enter. And because of Blox Fruit's little glitch where you can go underneath it, it does allow you to go through here. So you go not over there, but over here. And then you drop into the middle one. Right next to the big sloped triangle. And these polygons. And so, then you want to go to the corner. You want to shift lock. Look under. Wait until you see the two edges. And see, if you do this wrong, it'll show you like that. But if you get the right angle, you can flash step in, and boom. You are in Pirate Domain. Now, let me go ahead and show you where the regular entrance is. And I will be going backwards, as far as I know. I will just be showing you all the boss locations, basically. So, over here, next to basically the entrance, whenever you enter, you want to go to the right, then you want to take the left path, and then whenever you see this, this is usually would be a hideout, but now it's a, but this one in particular is Beautiful Pirate Domain's entrance. And so, you have to be level 1950 to enter and go back. But, since there is that little glitch, you can just press the home button. And currently, I have it set to the island I'm supposed to be at. And so, then, another boss that you have to defeat is Captain Elephant. And, I'm going to there right now. And so he usually spawns generally in this area. Still recording? Yep. But, let's hope that the file doesn't get corrupt. And this is the first time I'm recording this, so let's hope it does its job. So, right now I am Buddha, which means I can traverse water easily. Now, hold on. So, if you go and use the portal, which will make it a lot less time-consuming if you've already defeated Rupindra. Now, sadly, I did not get the recording of me summoning and defeating Rupindra all on my own, but it was relatively easy. You just have to keep your distance right out of his reach, and you want to use your long sword. Preferably one with more knockback. And so, another sword that you can use is Rengoku, which I will be showing you in the next video. So, on Castle of the Sea, I will be showing you also where to get, how and where to get Rupindra to spawn. So, every 10 minutes, a elite NPC spawns, and you want to go to the Elite Hunter, and you want to press yeah. So, we check around. And, sorry guys, my mic crashed again. So, I think I'm just gonna not use that. So, but, Rupindra usually spawns over here. And I don't know where exactly he spawned, because whenever I spawned him, my game lagged out. But luckily, my friend was in the server and was able to stop the server from despawning. Now, these exactly, I don't know what these do, but I'm just going to try and do this. Now, I know I'm getting a little distracted, but this could be, never mind. So, let's go to Hydra Island, which is actually where another boss is. So, I showed you how to get to Beautiful Pirate, but I don't know if I've shown you where to get to Island Empress. So all bosses have spawned now, so this will make my job a lot easier. So Island Empress usually spawns at the temple, on Hydra Island, up at the top. Right in the middle is where you can find the higher level area. Now, Hydra Island is just one area, as in, there are multiple in Haunted Castle, but you don't need to go to Haunted Castle, as far as I'm concerned, because I didn't have to go there. And so, my friend was kind enough to actually show me how to get Rainbow Haki, and so that was very nice of him. And so, there was Island Empress. If we use observation, you can see that if a beautiful pirate would like to render, I don't know if beautiful pirate has the same amount of like spawn time. But I'm guessing not. Now, guys, the reason why my stats are so wonky is because they're really not good with the stats I had earlier. Because sword just generally did not give me energy. So, devs, if you are watching this video, please make it so that each stat can give you energy and defense. Please and thank you. Now, on with the video. So, I'm going to be going to Diablo, which I think we don't gain too much, but you can do this whenever you first enter Third Sea, I believe, and Diablo should be spawning near anytime soon. And then my thing likes to not act up anymore. How wonderful. So another thing I'm going to say for another video is how to get dragon scales. So if you go to Port Town, which is where you actually spawn, also, I don't know why, but my character looks very unique. I haven't seen anyone that looks like me quite. Well, I've never seen a character like mine. Now, guys, if you would like to help me make better videos, like 24-hour challenges, then please hit that subscriber button, watch all the videos, and hit that like button. Don't know if I said that. But if you stayed with me this far, I'm glad. Alright? So we only have a few more to go. So over here is Kilo Admiral. And sorry for using observation haki the whole entire time. I know it does make things darker, but it is much easier for me to see the enemies, so it will just have to be this way. And I might get people being like, oh, well, you don't have to do it that way. But, I kinda do, because I don't know if they've spawned. And sometimes they load a little bit out. But, here's Kilo Admiral at the tree, at the Great Tree, and he is inside the big tree. Now, he is a little bit more difficult to defeat than Island Empress, but do not worry, he is easy if you have Buddha. Now, I will in another video be showing you how to get Electric Claw, which is what a lot of people get. And stay tuned for bonus videos. Please subscribe, and it helps out a lot. So that was Kilo Admiral. Then I believe the last one should be Stone. So if we go over to Port Town, and guys, I don't know about you, but the like way that Roblox renders in its stuff is kind of weird, like, because it's like a 2D and like the effects follow around. So guys, if you would please help me make more videos, better quality. And, who knows, I might be saving up for some. Now, guys, whenever we do get a constant roll-in with fruit, I will be doing giveaways with fruit. I will also be doing giveaways once I get fruit notifier, which is actually what I'm currently saving up for. But, on with the video. If you would, please donate to me and adopt me. I am Shiny Miner Legacy, as seen here, just without the YT. But here is stone, which you can also get the pilot's helmet from stone, which makes you 130% faster. Which, if you have Mink V3, that is the same speed as your agility. So, essentially, there's... I'll show you guys. But, he didn't drop it, but that's okay. So, I will be showing you guys what it does to Minks. So, if we find it... Here it is. See, I am going much faster, and then agility is insane. But I like to keep on the Valkyrie helm since it is a token of defeating Rip Indra and is a rare drop. But I hope you guys enjoyed. Please hit that subscriber button and like button. Watch all the other videos. And hope you enjoyed. And remember, stay scaly.